The Pfister Automotive Group has been the culmination of automotive excellence, racing pedigree, and pretentious snobbery for nearly a century. Our consistency in design remains unbroken, a timeless form we couldn't be bothered to change. Generations will wither, but the Pfister silhouette will remain indefinite. So why not take your place in our sportiest model yet, or buy the other model? Not like anyone's gonna notice. Pfister. Excellence the poor simply wouldn't understand. The newest Spot the Difference addition to Pfister's lineup of Comets is finally upon us. And it's... okay, I love it. I mean, if a figure this old is in the forefront of motorsports and automotive sales still, they gotta be doing something right. The Comet S2 is the best-looking iteration of a family recipe, going back to the dawn of the post-war era. Of course, since the man behind Pfister has served his time-out sentence for his crimes, we can look past Pfister's dark history of developing tanks for an empire of evil, and of course the cultural war crime of introducing the world to the Weevil. There, I did it, there's your obligatory reference to the bad guys in the Second World War. Since you can't mention Pfister without someone chiming in, "Hey, didn't they help the Nazis build tanks and burger farzigs?" The type of people that no one wants to talk to at parties, the ones you pity invite, hoping they won't actually attend. You know, the guys who call themselves history buffs, because they seem to know internet contrarian facts that everybody else does or doesn't give a shit to know. Where was I? Comets? Oh, yeah. Where the 811 feels like a funky hidden experimental track on the B-side of an album, the S2 is an A-side hit single that everybody knows and loves. Or at least won't publicly admit to liking. It's okay, the purists scare me too. Speaking of tracks, the Germans have a prolific history of being snarky about their cars. So you know full well they're gonna brag that it shaved off a whole 0.8 seconds on its 20th run at the track. But for any other country that doesn't have a superhighway governed by Darwinism instead of speed limits, this means relatively little. Matter of fact, the half-month-long title of fastest sports car means that your comfort and convenience are squeezed out of the product with every drop of PR Pfister decides to bathe itself in. Now, I can hear you calling from the future and saying that it all depends on the package you buy. There are some of us out there who like our Comet experience to have as little amenities as possible. This is true. The base model will have creature comforts like working AC and something that never pairs to your iFruit phone when you need it to. You could also make the argument that the commuter experience is what the Neon or the Growler is built for. But if the car that most of us are going to become geriatric saving for is as comforting as being locked in a room with a rabid raccoon, haven't we sacrificed too much? Absolutely not. The S2 is like a cruise missile with an active aero spoiler, an unrestrained rocket in the line, and a steady scalpel in the turns. Just be careful you don't drive too aggressively. Otherwise, the only rocket you're gonna look like is a launch failure. Keep our old friend Galileo and his ramblings in mind when you hit the apex of a chicane, because the S2 will switch to the opposite direction faster than you can soil your seat. What can be said has already been said a hundredfold. Pfister's reputation begets their hubris, and the Comet S2 is an example of this hubris. To consider the purchase of a Comet a gamble is about as dicey as opening a zero-risk maze savings account. Drive this car. Temporarily ignore Pfister's motorsport resume, and the stat nerds who recite it ad verbatim. Experience what it means to be as powerful as you look, not by taste or wallet, but by speed and handling alone. The tired expression of insanity has been famously attributed to the act of repeating an action and aims of new results. The only difference here is Pfister repeats the same actions in the anticipation of insanity.